Okay, so everything's dry and we can go ahead with the next section. And there's really no set rule about what to do in what order. The typical rule is to go from light to dark in watercolor, but some watercolor artists even start with dark. And I like to get a little bit of a range of darks, lights, and mediums just to start getting a feel for the layout. And you can see I've already done this. The eyes are pretty dark. This is really light. And here's some of our medium tones. I just like to kind of build it up several tones at a time just so everything's balanced and I can kind of see it develop. So I think I'm just gonna stick the nose in now. I'm gonna get this all wet because, again, I want this all to be soft. There's hardly any hard edges. If you really look at the picture, there's really no extra hard edges except maybe the edge of his nose right here. So I'm gonna try to be careful there and not go over that boundary, but the rest of his nose is kind of soft. So just kind of moistening all that. Then I'm gonna scrub my brush pretty well in the black. And with this black, most blacks, no matter what brand or color you use, they're pretty granular. They're pretty granular, so they're really great at lifting out later. So I will probably go back out and lift out highlights anyway. So if this spreads a little bit, it's not the end of the world. I want to be real careful with this edge though. Because there are little highlights in his nose that I'm kind of painting right over, really. And then later, it will be no problem to go back in and lift those out a little bit. So when you're working with black, just remember you can do that. And sometimes it ends up having a much better effect anyway if you paint it in and then go back and lift it out, because when you lift it out, that's a very softening effect too. I like that effect, so it really gives it a nice feel of realism. So don't be afraid to do that. Going back in here with some lighter, putting some water on my brush, then blotting. I'm just blotting like this to get the extra water out so I can paint this lighter area. It's getting too dry, actually. I'm getting all these hard edges, so I'm just gonna erase that kind of. And I wanna go back in later and re-wet that because I wanna keep this really soft. Okay. While that is kind of setting, I can go ahead and put some light little details in right here. He's got a little shadow by his eye that kind of makes his eyelid. Eyes are pretty subtle usually, just around the eye with humans and with animals a lot of times, and you just want to get those, all those little creases right so that the eye looks realistic. Just refining the eye now. For some of the refining, I'm going to have to take this little, I've got a piece of masking in there, and it's kind of getting in the way of getting the just the right detail. So I'll have to go in and work on that. Eyes are tricky. You have to get them just right, and sometimes I have to kind of very carefully go back in and scrub things out and put things in and get it just right. And that eye looks totally messed up right now, and I'm not going to worry about it because I'll be able to go in later when I take that masking out and refine it. The masking is really in the way. Okay. So don't freak out too much. I mean, you can always go back in later and fix things up, which I will be doing in this one. Just really want to get these eye shapes right. It can be really tricky, can't it? Got to be careful to really paint what you see instead of what you think you see. And a good way to learn to do that is to paint upside down as an exercise. I would highly recommend that. That's there's a book called Drawing with the Left Side of the Brain, or maybe it's Drawing with the Right Side of the Brain. I can never keep it straight, but that's a really good book on how to learn how to paint what you see instead of what you think your brain sees, because your brain has its own opinions, and a lot of times it is indeed wrong. So I'm going to go in and block in his mouth because it's bugging me that it's like not right here. So really, if I do it the right way, though, I'll put my lights in first, which is kind of a bluish gray. He's got a little bit of pink in his jaw there, so I'm just gonna drop that in. And then go right back in. I'm gonna add a tiny bit of burnt sienna to my brush. I'm keeping my brush really dry in this next step because I just want soft edges. I don't want it to run everywhere. I'm gonna blot my brush, make sure it's not too wet. Get more black on my brush and go in and put some of these details in while I got a nice moist wash in here so I can get these, because most of this is all, again, soft edges in here. So you wanna try to keep it as soft as you can. The more accurate you can get the tones in this wet stage with animals and people and a lot of things, the better, because for some reason, like I've said again and again, this softness really adds something. Now I'm gonna totally rinse my brush out, just get a little bit of black and a little bit of moisture, and blend over this pink because this pink is a little overwhelming. I'm gonna blot again. I don't wanna create cauliflower, which I already have kind of, but that's okay because there is some texture in this dog's mouth in this area. And I just wanna get it right. And a lot of times at this stage, what you can do is just let it dry. See how hard this edge looks and how kind of fakey it looks? I don't know, I just don't like it. So, even now, I'm going to go over with a fairly dry brush. It's just moist, you know. You can't squeeze any water out of it, but it's still pretty moist. I'm just going to go over this edge and soften it. Because if you really look at this picture, it's not a completely hard edge, even here with the black against his... the black of the gums, it's not completely a hard line. Okay, so just gonna soften all that up.